Baseline, as you probably know, is a standardized framework that lets you know exactly which web platform features are safe to use across major browsers. Showing this visually in a video is actually quite challenging. And this is exactly where baseline status for video comes in. It's an online app I developed that lets you easily create something like this. Here's how it works. You will find the link in the description, so check it out and play with it yourself. In a nutshell, baseline status for video is this simple online app that lets you record this screen area and then easily import it into your video editing software to use in your videos. There are a number of options in the sidebar that you can use. The most important feature is, of course, feature ID that lets you change which feature to show in the baseline status widget. You can use any web platform feature right here, and if you're not sure which ID you're looking for because not all feature IDs are obvious, you can open this link right here, which will lead you to GitHub page where you can search for the feature that you want. For example, let's search for the heading pseudo class. And right here I see heading selectors, and this is probably what I want. Heading pseudo classes, of course, so I'm gonna use heading selectors as my feature ID. Let's paste this right here, and immediately I see heading pseudo classes with limited availability. It's not supported in any other browsers yet. Let me give you a hint. Currently, it's only available in Firefox behind the feature flag. That's why you don't see it highlighted here as available. In any case, you can tweak those values here and change the widget to look exactly as you want. You can scale it up, you can tweak the margins, you can turn it into dark mode, and you can change the transition function. Of course, you can preview exactly what every transition looks like, so you can decide which one to use. The video background color here is actually a green screen option, because later when you import the video that you get from this app into your video editing software, you will want to remove the background so only this widget is actually visible. This green color is actually a standard color that is used for green screens that you can then remove with the Chroma Key feature in a video editing software, but in my testing I found that this particular red actually works really well because it has the least overlap with these logos here, because the green color is actually conflicting with the edge green right here and with the chrome green right here. So in my experience, it was a little bit easier to adjust this red with the Chroma Key to remove the background, but I'm gonna show you exactly how this works in a moment. If you want to see the exact preview of what the video will look like, you can hit the preview button here, and once you do, the mouse cursor will disappear, but it's still available, and if you move it around it will reappear. If it doesn't reappear, you can always click anywhere on the screen and the preview will end. Exactly the same for the actual recording. If you want to stop the recording, you can hit the escape key on your keyboard, or you can just click the mouse button and you will get out of this full screen preview where the mouse is not visible. Another feature that I want to mention here is feature description. I'm going to enable it. By default, this will show you the default description that comes with this particular widget, baseline status widget. This feature is not in baseline, or this feature is in baseline, whatever is the case for the current feature you have selected. But if you enter any text here, this default text will be replaced by the text that you enter. For example, you might want to say, check the link in the description for up-to-date information, because the browser support changes from time to time, and if you're recording videos about cutting edge features that are not in the baseline yet, then you might want to redirect users to Can I Use or to actual MDN entry so they can check the current state of the actual feature. I will mention here that this feature description field actually supports HTML, so you can tweak and style the message that you're going to display here. For example, let's wrap this into small tag. I can use any CSS I want directly inline here as a style attribute, or I can actually even use a style tag. And then I can target any element that is available within this widget. And if I want to style the entire widget, I can actually target it using the host pseudo element. Let me show you exactly how. Host, and let's set background color, for example, to yellow. I will have to add important here to override the default value. And for example, let's add HR element right here, just so we have a clear separator between the actual widget and our additional info. I will remove this and I'm going to actually turn off this feature. I don't want to show it right now. All right, so let's record the actual video. I'm going to hit record here. The browser asks me to allow screen recording. I want to mention here also that you will probably need to enable screen recording permissions in your system for the browser that you're using. This app actually works best with Google Chrome. It works in Safari and Firefox as well, but their screen sharing options are not as ideal because both of those browsers actually record the entire browser interface, while Google Chrome allows you to capture only the actual screen of the web page, which means that you will have the least amount of work if you're using Google Chrome in the post-production. All right, I'm going to hit allow here. The interface will disappear and the screen will be recorded. I set it up in a way that screen recording is as short as possible. So all you're going to get is animation in and animation out. And then in the post-production, you will probably need to use freeze frame feature to show the widget for a little bit more time on the screen, because by default, it's going to slide in and slide out immediately, which is probably not what you want your users to see. Now that we recorded the screen, we can preview it right here. This is what it looks like. So I'm going to download it. And once I download it, I can use it in my screen recording software. So right now I'm going to jump into ScreenFlow and show you exactly how to remove the background, how to set Chroma Key to remove the background, and how to use that clip that we just created in your videos. I'm in the ScreenFlow now and I already have one of my videos opened. So what I need to do now is import the clip that I've downloaded. It's right here. I'm going to just hit open. And once it's in my screen recording software, I can add it to my stage. I will select a frame that comes a little bit later so I can see the widget on the screen. And I will now set the chroma key filter here. Remove green screen feature or chroma key feature is probably available in any screen editing software. So if you're not sure where to find it, check documentation of your video editing software. In any case, in ScreenFlow, it's right here on the filter and effects. In the background removal section, I'm going to select chroma key, hit add, and the color is already pre-selected. So I can see the background has disappeared and the widget is visible, but it's not ideal yet. So I'm going to zoom in a bit. Those colors are a little bit off, so I'm going to need to tweak those values right here. I'm going to tweak the white clip, an angle as well, just to get the best possible result. This seems to be pretty much okay right now, so I will zoom out again and I will actually adjust the position on the screen so it looks a little bit better. I'll scale it up. There we go. This looks pretty much okay. So let's preview this. I've actually disabled the sound of this video so it's not confusing. So this is what the actual video will look like, but it's not on the screen long enough. So I'm going to actually use freeze frame feature here at the moment when the widget is on the screen. I will cut the clip. I will move this to the right and I will add freeze frame here. In the ScreenFlow, you will find it under clip, add freeze frame. And once you do, this frame will be frozen for as long as you want. So you can give users plenty of time to actually process the information visually. So now the widget is on the screen a little bit longer thanks to my freeze frame. And essentially, this is all you need to know about using baseline status for video. So if you're creating technical videos that are talking about web platform features, then you might want to use baseline status for video to show the status browser support of the feature that you're talking about. This is especially useful for features that are already in the baseline, but your audience might not be aware of it and you don't specifically mention it in the video. You can just pull up the widget on the screen where it shows feature is in the baseline. Let's set it to margin here. Baseline are widely available in all browsers, and that way your viewers will immediately know that they can use this feature safely in production. You can find me on all social networks under CSS Weekly. So if you ever use this in one of your videos, please let me know. I would love to see it. And I would love to actually feature you in the about section of this app under who's using baseline status for video. If you know somebody who is creating videos and could use this app, please send them the link. Or if you want, even better, share the link on your social media profiles. I would really appreciate it. If you have any suggestions about improvements, potential new features, or if you find any bugs, just let me know either on social media, as I already mentioned, or directly on GitHub. You can create an issue and I will check it out as soon as I can. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Ryan Yambor. I will see and hear you in a different baseline status widget, or rather, in a next video.